Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I have come once again with another video as promised. So this class will be a continuation of my last video in which I had explained in detail what is a finite verb and what is a non-finite verb, right? So I hope you remember everything that we have been learned in the last class. So before moving on, I would like to recall what you had learned in the last class, okay? So what is a finite verb, guys? A verb that changes according to the time of action, that is present, past and future, the number of people doing the action and the person doing the action, right? And non-finite verbs, the verbs that do not change their forms in any of the cases. So we have already learned these things in the previous classes. In case you haven't seen my previous video, please go and check and then come back to this video so that it will be helpful for you to learn in an easy manner. So let's get started. So gerund. We all know that non-finite verbs have three kinds: gerund, participle and infinitives. So today we are going to learn what is a gerund first, and I will also give you multiple of examples to make you understand clearly, and this will also enable you to identify a gerund in a sentence, and also you will learn how to use a gerund in a sentence. Okay, so let's get started. What is a gerund? A gerund is a verbal noun. What do I mean by a verbal noun? A verb that acts as a noun or performs the action of a noun. We know that noun is a naming word, a name of a person, place, animal and thing. And a verb is a doing word that shows some action. So when that action word, particularly when you add ing to a verb's base form, see, I have written a gerund is a noun made form a from a verb root plus ing. So when you add ing to the base form of a verb, you make it verb's continuous form, like going, doing, eating, sleeping. And when these words, when these doing words perform like a noun, not like a verb, we call them a gerund. So a gerund can be used as a subject, as an object and as a predicative noun. We all know that only noun and pronoun can be used as a subject or an object. A subject means a subject is a noun or pronoun that performs the action. A sentence tells us something about the subject. So as we know that, or as we have already known that gerund is a verbal noun, a verb that acts like a noun, so definitely it can be a subject. And what is an object? The words that answers the question what and whom are known as an object. And what is a predicative noun? A predicative noun is a noun that is used after a linking verb. For example, he is an engineer. Here is a linking word or linking verb. Is joining or relating he, the subject he, with engineer. So engineer is here predicative noun. So what did we learn? That a gerund acts like a noun. Instead of being, in spite of being a verb, it actually acts like a noun. And it is made from a verb root plus ing. And it can be used as a subject, an object or a predicative noun. Now let's observe these three following sentences to get a clear understanding. Read the first sentence. I am swimming now. Second, swimming is a very good exercise. Third, I love swimming. So in these three sentences, we have the common verb swimming. As I said earlier, that a base form, you need a base form to form a gerund. So base form is swim, and you have added ing to it, swimming. It has become verb's continuous form, right? Which I have used as a gerund, or which I can also use as a verb. So I am swimming now. Here the word swimming has acted as a verb, as it is telling us about the action that has been performed. Someone is swimming. I am swimming now. I is the subject, am is helping verb, and swimming is the main verb, right? So swimming has been used as a verb. Now look at in the next sentence. Look at the next sentence. Swimming is a very good exercise. So if I ask you, what is a very good exercise according to you? So you will say, ma'am, according to me, swimming is a very good exercise. So here swimming has become actually a naming word, a noun, a name of a physical exercise, not a verb. Because here the word swimming is not telling us about a particular action, but it is indicating a naming word, a name of a physical exercise which is very good and healthy. Sorry, which is very good for your health. So swimming is a very good exercise. Here swimming is a noun. So definitely it will be a gerund. And another thing to be pointed out over here is that swimming has been used as a subject. What is a subject? A subject is a noun or pronoun that performs a certain action. So here the sentence is giving us information about an exercise, swimming. So swimming is a subject. We have already learned that gerund can be used as a subject and an object. In the next sentence, I love swimming. So what do you love? I love swimming. I love what? So swimming is an object. As I have already told you, an object is something that answers the question what and whom. So swimming is answering the question what. It is a direct object. It has been used as a direct object and it is also performing the action of a noun. So swimming is a gerund. Now let's look at these three sentences again. I love dancing. Dancing is my hobby. She is dancing with lots of grace. Now in the third sentence, last sentence, look at the last sentence. She is dancing with lots of grace. So I will ask, how is she dancing? You will say, with lots of grace and passion. So here dancing is actually a doing word or action word, because the word dancing is telling us about the action that has been happening. What is going on? Dancing. She is subject, is helping verb, and dancing is a main verb, right? So verb. In the next two sentence, I love dancing. So you love what? What do you love? Dancing. So dancing is a subject. Dancing has been used here as a naming word, as a name for an art. Dancing is an art. Dancing is my hobby. What is your hobby? The name of your hobby, naming words. So try to understand that how I can use a verb as a noun at the same time as a verb in a sentence. When I am saying that I like singing, you know, I like singing. It means that singing is something that I love. Singing is a name of an art that I love. That is my passion. But when I will say that I am singing now, please don't disturb me. I am singing now. Right? So singing is here a doing word. I am singing now. It has become a doing word. Some activity. So now how to identify gerund in a sentence? See how you will identify. Now we always do this whenever we identify a particular sentences. We have to ask a question and see whether the verb is answering the question what or not. Because a noun or pronoun most of the time answers a question what if it has been used as a subject or object. So I love reading. What do you love? Reading. Reading is the object of your love. So reading has been used as an object and it is a gerund. This is not indicating anything that has been happening. Reading just a name of the object of your love. Only noun or pronoun act as an object, and only noun and pronoun can be used as the subject in a sentence. So whenever a verb ing form, has been used as a subject or object, that can be definitely a gerund and nothing else. That will be definitely a gerund and nothing else. Because we all already know that a A noun and pronoun can be used as an object or as a subject. See, he was startled by her shouting. Shouting is an object of the preposition by. He was startled by what? See, this is also answering the question what. Traveling is a good way to expand your worldview. What is a good way to expand your worldview? Traveling. So traveling is acting as a subject and is also answering the question what. So whenever in the exams you will be given sentences and your teacher will ask you to identify gerund, participle and infinitives, what you will do? You will find out verb ing, okay, verb continuous form, and then you will see whether it has been used as a noun. How can you do that? First, by asking question. It will surely answer the question what. And secondly, if it does not, then you will apply the second rule, that is, you know, only noun and pronoun act as an object or subject. So if your gerund or verb ing has been used as a subject or object, then it will be definitely a gerund. Clear? Okay. Next, how to use gerund in a sentence? In class 8, okay, in class 8, ICSE and CBSE boards, there are question papers which I have seen, actually I have gone through, I have seen that teachers has given two sentences, have given two sentences and asked the students to join those sentences using a gerund, participle or infinitive. So how will you join the sentences using a gerund? Just in this way. She will travel. The first sentence is she will travel. The next sentence is this is something she enjoys the most. What is something she enjoys the most? Ask the question again. What is something she enjoys the most? What? Traveling. See, you have already made it a gerund by using the verb base form travel and adding ing to it. So this is something she enjoys the most. What is something that she enjoys? Traveling. Now use the word traveling to join the sentence. She will travel as or because traveling is something she enjoys the most. So in this way, you will use gerund to join two sentences. What you will do, first you will go through the sentence properly, try to understand the meaning, and then try to ask the question to find out which is the verb that I can make a gender with. Understood? So let me sum up again. What is a gender? A gender is a verbal noun, a verb that is formed from a verb's base form plus ing, and that acts like a noun, that performs the action of a noun, a naming word. A gerund can be used as a subject, an object and predicative noun. I have given you several examples to make you understand properly. I have given you clear ideas so that you can identify gerund in a sentence, and I have already told you the tricks which you are going to apply to join two sentences by using gerund. So I hope you guys have understood, or I have been able to clear your concept, build a good concept and clear your doubts. So in the next video, I will be discussing about participles and infinitives. So if you like this video, please don't forget to like, share and comment, and please subscribe and help me and support me so that I can make more videos, more useful videos for you. Till then, thank you. Goodbye.